Have you ever asked yourself, why is the news so negative? It's taken me 7 years to find out why this is, what effect this has on us, but more importantly, what we can do about it. Please watch my trailer and help bring this book to life. Pledge what you can to become part of this movement and help kickstart a consumer revolution. Thank you.
The purpose of the news is to engage and inform, empower people to bring about reform, but their words are being lost by the noise of the storm. We hear about disaster, murder, conflict, and violence. And after a while, this becomes white noise like silence. Because when there's a bias for the negative, we lose becoming sensitive. And instead, we become emotionally dead. You see, this negativity has been shown to be destructively informing me, dividing me from society by creating this fear and anxiety. For many, they watch helplessly as if we're damned to be. But that's not the only story of the fate of our humanity. Let's hear about progress, acknowledge solutions. This excess of negativity, it's like mental pollution. When we do see good news, it's misrepresented. We hear cats being saved from trees and the conversation is ended, saved instead for an and finally. But finally, these stories of possibility are being shown to be a vital story for society. We need to learn about how problems are being solved, issues resolved, for the sake of our souls. Not for ignorant bliss, but because we are better than this. We don't need sugarcoating or positive spins. Again, that's a cynical view that this conversation underpins. And don't get it confused with entertainment, PR or fluff. Enough is enough. It's rigorous journalism reporting on progress, reporting on problems, but not ignoring success. We publicize failure, corruption and shame, but when it comes to human potential, it's not treated the same, and the hypocrisy is killing me. Are you kidding me? They point the finger at every other industry, but leave them be. As this excess of negativity increases in velocity, atrocity, chasing more controversy. But where is the nobility in preying on morbid curiosity? I feel cheated, defeated by newspapers' allegiance to profits and clickbaits, regardless of if it generates hate and drums up the nation into a fearful state. Some people find it too much to take. And then the stories become lost because people switch off. But if we want a nation that's engaged and informed, it's time to reform. Make a new norm, empower, inspire, help us achieve higher. Report the good in other people, not just replay their evil. If we witness the unbelievable, it makes it more achievable. A solution seems more feasible. The only option now is to freeze or fall. After all, the truth of the world includes the good and the bad, the happy and the sad. So why would you just tell one half of the story? It leaves us in mourning, unable to see that the new day is dawning. The power lies in us becoming aware, to ensure they take more care about the stories they tell when they look at the world out there. And why should we care? Because the truth is, the news is an organization that's intrusive of our minds, and it's a matter of time before their words become our thoughts, shaping our opinions more and more. So what we're asking for, as I've said before, is rigorous journalism reporting on progress, reporting on problems, but not ignoring success. It may sound idealistic, it's been labelled naive, but let me assure you, this is not an ignorant plea. The research says it's obvious, and to ignore it is preposterous. So it's time for the consumers to take a stand, because the industry will listen to us.